Hello from Chem Help ASAP. We've reviewed all the stages of radical reactions in other videos. Let's now see a real radical reaction, the radical halogenation of alkanes. Across the top of the screen is the overall reaction for the radical halogenation of a very simple alkane, methane. Like all radical reactions, this process involves initiation, propagation, and termination stages. For initiation, the reaction involves Br2, a common radical initiator, with light on the reaction, H nu, the Br-Br bond will homolyze and form two bromine radicals. This is the initiation step. For propagation, we begin with a Br radical from the initiation step. A Br radical reacts with the CH on methane. Here is the mechanism. The product of this step, the first propagation step, is HBr and methyl radical. For the second propagation step, the CH3 radical reacts with another molecule of Br2 to form bromomethane, our ultimate product, and a new Br radical. If we were to add these two steps, all the radicals would cancel. BrBr cancels, methyl radical cancels with a methyl radical, and what would drop out is the same as our overall reaction. That's exactly what we should get if we've written the propagation steps correctly. For termination, we can select any radical from the initiation and propagation steps and put them together. There are only two radicals, Br dot and the methyl radical. That gives us three possible termination products, Br2, bromomethane, or ethane, from two methyl radicals combining. Because radical concentrations are so low, products from termination reactions are also very low. Radical halogenation is a very important reaction. In other playlists, we have learned all kinds of vital reactions of alkyl halides, including the SN2, E2, SN1, and E1. In order to do these reactions, we need a way to make alkyl halides. Radical halogenation gives us quick access to many different halides. Radical halogenation is not limited to bromination. Chlorinations with Cl2 and iodinations with I2 are also possible. Because of differences in bond energies, each halogen has its own features and bugs. I tend to stick with Br2, but the other halogens can and do work. One final point. Radical halogenations are an example of a substitution reaction. From carbon's perspective, on methane, we're substituting a bromine in place of a hydrogen. If you're watching these videos in my suggested order, then you've seen other substitutions, SN1, SN2, electrophilic aromatic substitutions, and nucleophilic substitutions via addition-elimination reactions. Radical halogenations are a fundamentally different type of substitution. That's the radical halogenation of alkanes, specifically methane. This video highlights how the halogenation fits with the principles of radical reactions. In the next video, we'll see factors to consider when halogenating larger alkanes.